get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Dunson Riley, Phyllis Diller, Brett Catalina, and Joyce Buellebaugh as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
For my first number, you got a good bunch out there, John? And there's a grand bunch out there in television land, as they say. And hey, we got a good group up here. What do you say, sailor? What's that say there?
Blue Moon Saloon.
Blue Moon
That's
Saloon.
That's where we're going.
I see. All right. Now, Mike, would you step down here, or if you would please, to this blue dot, and as soon as you get off there, we'll turn the merry-go-round around, and bring the star wheel in, if you please, and continue. Mike has won $250. That means the least he'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. And we're going to give him a chance to spin the star wheel to double his money and play for $5,000 instead of $2,500. So good luck to you. We'll all root for a double. Here we go.
Okay, Michael. Let's double it up.
Nothing, Joyce. Just represents a great deal of money to him.
This week.
That's right. And it's your last.
Say 5,000 fish, but don't worry about it.
$5,000 at stake. All right.
Please concentrate.
Yes, good luck. Double decker blank. Double decker blank. Well, Joyce wrote down the first thing that came into her mind on that one, and that's usually the best way to go here. Let's see if it works this time, and if you've got any ESP going with Joyce Buellebaugh. What do you say to that, Mike? Double-decker bus. Bus? Well, you're not a New Yorker. That's really kind of a New York answer.
I can't believe it. I'm so embarrassed the third time.
The third time? About what?
A double, not being able to get anything right. That's what I thought of right away.
Oh, yes.
Again? That's what I wrote.
$5,250. All right. Yeah. Mike Connelly.
Now, let's bring your opponent back here and play game number two. You ready for that? Okay, here we go. All right, as soon as it stops, Mike, you can get aboard. Welcome back, Shirley.
Hi, thank you.
We missed you.
Oh, I missed this place.
Now, he's very excited because he has $5,250. And we're very happy about that. Now, Shirley, let's begin the second and final game and ask you to choose A or B.
B, please.
B, please. She said, B, please. That B, please.
Gary said that pirate must be an athlete. Instead of a peg leg, he's got a blank. You're never going to get
it. Did you hear about the pirate who had two wooden legs?
No, what about the pirate who had two wooden legs?
He burned to the ground.
You know what he said when he got to the ground?
No, Fred. What did he say when he got to the ground?
Welcome to Fantasy Island. The play.
I don't like the answer.
Well, remember, it's a round one question, and there's the rule. All right. Gary said that pirate must be an athlete. Instead of a peg leg, he's got a...
A cast?
Did you hear me say athlete was the operative word?
Yes. Well, you know, they get hurt, you know, football players.
Oh, you mean, he broke the leg and he had a cast on it. All right, that was her reasoning on it. What did you say, Dave?
Well, I said instead of a peg leg, he had a pole vault.
A pole vault.
There it is.
That's where the Polish people keep their money. But
that's where the Polish people keep their money, the vault.
That is cute. I'm kind of enamored with Fred. I go in and out, but a lot of the time I'm really kind of crazy about him. Polish vault.
That's two of those.
In pole vault.
You stole it from him, right? Or vice versa?
Of course, because I couldn't get anything.
Back.
Ben, like in a baseball game.
Oh, and he didn't want to show that answer to me.
Back.
Pole vault is better.
A bat?
Bat would, you know, a baseball player's bat would be the closest simulation of a peg leg.
Are you trying to convince me?
Yeah. See, it's a...
I'll never believe it.
The pirate must be an athlete.
We get it. You got
stabbed. No, because he had a sneaker.
Instead of a peg leg, he's got a sneaker.
Uh-huh.
Nobody understood this question.
I thought it was a perfectly understandable question, and being that I answered the last one on the last show so well, I said baseball bat.
Baseball bat, yes.
It was a rock.
What they were answering here was any sporting implement like a 9-iron, a baseball bat, a tennis racket, anything.
A pole vault.
A pole vault, certainly.
That would have been funny, a tennis racket.
Substitute the peg leg for.
A pogo stick.
Pogo stick would be good. What do you say?
I like tennis racket. I wish I'd thought of it. I was thinking about pirates and water in Boston and crewing, so I said an oar.
An oar would be all right.
It would be handier.
That's right.
All right. I hated that question.
Now, let's see if we have one of equal difficulty for Mike.
No, it wasn't good.
Old Oscar the reporter is really old. I don't want any of your half-hearted attempts here to respond to me. Now, if you want to do it, do you want to do it or don't you want to do it?
Yeah.
Last chance. Old Oscar the reporter is really old.
Cleared out your sinuses, didn't it, sweetheart?
The first fire he ever covered was the burning of blank. Old Oscar the reporter. Ready, David? Old Oscar the reporter is really old. The first fire he ever covered was the burning of...
Rome.
Rome. Rome, that was a long time ago.
You bet it was, baby.
All right, there's one for Mike. The burning of.
You know what? I'm really embarrassed. You know who Shirley looks like?
Who?
Not anybody famous. She looks like a wonderful roommate I had whose name was Marsha Rowley about 106 years ago.
That's what brought it
here. Long
this,
before
this
that.
Goes back further.
Goes back. I mean, there was the burning of the bush.
The burning of the bush. That's really going back a long
you
way.
You and the roommate went way back.
Yes, indeed.
What was her name?
Marsha Roby. Hi, Marsha.
That's sweet. Yeah. You know what Marsha said?
What?
Come, Brett, come to the balcony and watch the burning of Rome. That's how I know.
Old Oscar the reporter was there and covered the burning of...
But he didn't completely cover it up.
He didn't?
No, it was Rome.
It was Rome.
Yeah.
That's great for him. What do you got for old Mike, Fred?
Let me just tune this up here.
Rome. Donkeys.
Don't do that.
Two speed readers talking at dinner.
It's so funny.
He is.
I have the definitive answer. Would you please read the last part of that, or the first part?
Old Oscar, the old reporter, really old. First fire you ever covered was the burning of...
Brett's bra.
Yeah. So, it's 4-0 in favor of Mike. Round 2 coming up in a moment or so right now, this for you. Here we go to round 2. Mike, your head will ask you to go first.
A.
A. Two people play. Joyce.
Yes.
And Brett. Are you ready, ladies?
The Dolly Sisters.
Weird Willie is so weird, he doesn't get out of bed feet first. He gets out of bed blank first.
He's no fool.
Write an answer there.
Weird Willie is so weird he doesn't get out of...
I can't answer this.
Weird Willie's so weird he got out of bed feet first. You don't play.
I know.
You love it.
We're trying to bring him up.
Anytime you're ready. Here we go, Mike. Weird Willie is so weird he doesn't get out of bed feet first. He gets out of bed blank first.
Head first.
Head first?
I would think that would be logical.
Mike said head first. What do you say to that?
Well, all the ladies in the audience know what breech birth is.
Yep.
I said butt first.
Butt first. So what came to your mind?
I had a child who was born breech birth.
He said head first.
Head first.
Ah, there's another one for Mike. He's got five. Now, Shirley, that means you need five to tie and six to win. So here we go. Ed has the world's most useless job.
What is it? No, he's... I have the world's most useless job. I'm sorry. But not for long.
Are you quite finished?
Yes, darling.
Big mouth?
Yes, darling.
Ed has the world's most useless job. He's a lifeguard at a blank. World's most useless job, a lifeguard at a blank.
I can't think of an answer.
What's new?
A winning.
They really are friends.
I mean, I want...
That. That's very good.
I want...
Very good.
Them as friends, who needs enemies?
I want to think of a... I want to set you something that's a winning answer for everybody.
Here we go. Shirley, Ed has the world's most useless job. He's a lifeguard at a blank.
Bathtub?
Lifeguard at a bathtub.
Yeah.
Bathtub.
Well...
I thought of that.
It's been splendid having you on the show, Shirley. What do you have?
I said a mirage.
A mirage. Yes. That's the thing you see when you're in the desert.
Did you see the water on the highway and there's no water at all? Right.
Now, you've got to match all of the other stars, Shirley, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. What have you got for Shirley?
Oh, Shirley, I'm sorry. I really racked my brain, which is not too hard a thing to do. But I said sandbox.
Sandbox. Yeah. So that means Mike wins another game. What do the rest of you have?
And take your spot where you know where.
We're going to say goodbye to Shirley. Many gifts will be coming your way from the match game.
Thank you.
Thank you for being with us.
It's been fun.
Goodbye, Shirley. I'll spin her off and spin a message for you. All right, here we go with Mike. Second time around. Now, Mike has a pretty good bundle already, $5,250, right? And he could add to those winnings right now with his go at the Super Match here. Let's see how it goes. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank cuff. Remember, 500 for the most popular, 250 for the second most popular, and 100 for the third most popular. Whom do you want?
Charles. Off the cuff.
There's one.
Brett.
I thought it was...
Oh, good. That's good. The last one.
French cuff.
French cuff?
Oh.
Oh, don't pick up.
Al Hutch, I helped him before.
What?
Oh, she's just so choice.
I'm sorry. Are you nervous of what I'm going to say? Handcuff.
That's right.
So we have handcuffs, off the cuff, and French cuffs. You want one of those or one of your own?
I've got to go with Charles, off the cuff.
No, no, I off think it's handcuffs.
The audience thinks you're wrong. They applauded most loudly for
handcuffs. Can the
man change?
Yeah. All right, stand right there, little dot. Let's find out what we've got up there. Off the cuff is what he says he wants. Let's give it to him. Is it under the $100 response? French
All right,
cuff.
Now I want that boo taken back.
Take
Ooh,
back your boo.
No, no, it's got to be
oob.
Oob.
That's right. That's the opposite of boo.
Right.
There. Let's see what we got out of the $250 response. Off the cuff. Again, Mike. Another $250.
Okay,
I really think the audience is going to be right this time.
This
I think.
Be prepared to stand up, George.
Is right. Let's see it,
and
please.
Get kissed.
Yes, it is. Okay. Now, again, the least you'll play for is $2,500, but again, you're going to spin the wheel and see if you can double it and play for $5,000 as you did last time. Good luck to you. Here we go. Just slid by.
Well.
All right.
Phyllis who?
Phyllis.
Phyllis in.
Stand right there. Face this way. Now, Phyllis, this time you will write your response, and he'll give a verbal response after you put your answer in that little slot there. Here it is.
Wasn't it? No, I guess it's a bar.
Drink blank. Drink blank. Drink blank.
That music makes me very nervous.
It does.
Could you turn the music down for Miss Diller, please? Oh, I, tense moment.
Just put it in the slot.
Put it in the slot.
All right, now she's finished.
Oh, boy.
Mike, if you give us the answer that she has written on the card, we give you $2,500 additional. What do you say?
Water.
Drink water, he says. You wouldn't say that? Probably a bunch of... What
nobody
do they say?
Would say that,
drink
right?
Drink milk?
I would!
You drink it all?
Water.
Water?
Well, he's a fish person.
Well, he's a fish person, naturally. You drink the water that the fish have been swimming around in?
No, bottled water.
Oh, you drink bottled water.
Remember W.C. Fields?
Yes.
Did you? There was a flood in Beverly Hills today.
There was?
Yeah, a Perrier truck sprung a leak.
He says drink water will match you for the $2,500.
Oh,
now,
boy.
Now you have to show and tell and...
I know. Well, if he'll split it with me, I'll say water.
Aha! Time, and we're going to do a little game in the audience in a moment or so, but right now, this message for you. Now, fortunately, we have a little time left over, and those people in the studio audience can have a chance to win some money. So, Joyce,
yes.
Would you write down an answer to this, please? Yard blank. Y-A-R-D blank. And I'll go down here and call on someone in the studio audience. Oh, all right. Let's find out who we got down here.
Got a good idea.
What's your name?
Bertha Israelian.
Where are you from, Bertha?
Canada.
What are you doing in Los Angeles?
On a bus tour.
Is a bus outside? No. Are you enjoying it here?
Sure are.
What's the most interesting thing you've done?
Oh, I don't know, everything.
I almost called on her.
That'll teach you to reach.
No, Bertha, you give us an answer to this, and if you match Joyce, you get $50. I have the cash in my hand. Yard blank. What do you say to that? Yard blank.
Yard stick.
Yard stick. Yes or no? Yard stick. Okay, Fred. Fred, this one is yours. Blank thrower. T-H-R-O-W-E-R. Blank thrower. Let's see who else we've got down the line here. Yeah. Where's this lady from?
I'm from Los Angeles right now, but originally from Vienna, Austria.
You don't sound like you're from Los Angeles or Austria. Okay. What's your name?
My name is Peppy Vine.
Peppy Vine? When did you change your name?
About 25 years ago when I got married.
Okay. How would you fill that blank in blank thrower?
Stone thrower.
Stone thrower, Fred?
Well, I said ball thrower.
Ball thrower. All right, so that's all the money we're going to give away. We thank you for your kind participation. Join us next time.
Some of our contestants will receive Panamax's Model 240D slide projector. Comes with cord-style handset control, super bright quartz halogen lamp system, and computer-designed optics with pinpoint images from Panamax. And from Arrow, this fireplace insert. Turn your fireplace into a furnace. Efficient airtight, circulates heat by means of a large built-in blower. Features decorative glass door and energy-efficient home accessory from Arrow. And the Ansco disc camera with fast f2.8 all-glass lens focusing down to 18 inches, motorized film advance, automatic sensor, electronic flash, and folding crystal grip from Ansco. And Heath Bits of Brickle adds a great almond topping flavor to just about every dessert, especially Bits of Brickle ice cream pie. And Maximum Strength Charcoal Plus, a new formula for head colds and cough. Opshon's Charcoal Plus clears nasal passages, dries runny nose, and controls cough. Use as directed.